Hi everyone, today we are going to make this bhindi or lady finger, which we call. Today we are going to make this, and along the way I'll be giving you some very good tips which will help you make lady finger come out all green and beautiful. Now what I do, first of all, I buy the lady finger from the market, and then I wash and store in this mesh. So what happens is all the water gets drained out and the lady fingers get dry, and it makes easy to make them. Now next I'm going to cut these lady fingers into very small pieces. I make it three ways: very small pieces, a little bit large pieces, and sliced pieces. All videos I'll be making in different kinds of bhindis, they'll be coming on. But here I am going to make bhindi with smaller pieces. Now what I am doing is slitting the top and the bottom of the bhindi, and after that I will be cutting the bhindis into smaller pieces. Now I've started cutting this bhindi into small pieces. The whole kg of bhindi has to be cut like this. You have to keep looking on the top here while cutting, so that if there are any insects inside — usually in bhindi there are insects, lady fingers — so you, while you're cutting, just keep the head towards you and cut like this, so that you can see if it's infected or not. As you can see, I'm making very small pieces of the bhindi. So now you can see my bhindi is cut, and the pieces are very fine, very small pieces. Vegetable taste is just as you cut it. The vegetable taste ultimately depends on how you have cut your vegetable. So I make my bhindi in three ways. I cut it very small, I cut it medium, and then third way I make it slitted. Just full bhindi slit in half. I'll put the videos later on. Plus I will sometimes make my bhindi with onions, and sometimes I do not. Today I am making it without onions. Now the ingredients, you can see, this is the cut bhindi. This is the butter. Friends, I am a very big fan of butter and ghee. And this is jeera, hing, and til or sesame seeds. And here you can see, this is 1 kg of bhindi, and I am using 2 teaspoons of dhania powder, 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder, 1 leveled teaspoon of haldi, and garam masala. Next I will be using this green chillies. I am not going to cut them into finer pieces, so that whoever is eating the sabzi can make out if they want to make. They have the option to remove it if they don't want to eat it. Then next I am going to use curry leaves. Curry leaves I put in this, and I prefer doing it like this, so that all the curry leaves gets pounded. And this is how it, you can see, and it is lot of curry leaf, but it will not come under your taste like you are eating curry leaves. When you don't pound them, people don't like curry leaves in their food. So this is my way of getting my family to eat lot of curry leaves. As you all know, it is very beneficial for your health. So my next step is to put the gas on. And the trick here which I wanted to share with you is that you have to make your vessel very, very hot. It has to be very hot to make green colored bhindi. So let's start. Here I can feel that my vessel is very, very hot, and now I will put some ghee. First I'll put a teaspoon of ghee, so that my jeera and sesame seeds are roasted well, like this. Here, and after this I put the curry leaf, and then I put my bhindi in it. Friends, this is the big tip here, that your vessel should be very, very hot, so that now you can just literally smell the roasted cumin seeds and hing or asafoetida. And next you are going to put the butter and just keep moving the vegetables. The flame has to be high here. We keep it on high. You can see it's high flame. I'll show you here. It is very high flame. You can see. You have to keep stirring the whole thing till the butter melts and the bhindi starts cooking. Just keep stirring on high flame. You don't have to. If you reduce the flame, the color of the bhindi turns very bad. It doesn't look that green. So if you want to look your sabji to be very green, then you have to just keep it on high flame and keep stirring it. I have been stirring this bhindi for almost 7-8 minutes, and as you can see, it's almost done. Now to make this kind of bhindi with green and all, you need to have a large bottom pan, like it makes the stirring very easy. Now I will add the masalas. This is 2 teaspoons of dhania powder, 1 teaspoon of lal mirch, red chili powder, turmeric 1 spoon, and 1/2 spoon of garam masala. I will add all this. Now you have to keep stirring. It's almost done now. In the end, we add the green chilies in the end. Otherwise, the green chilies become very discolored if you add them in the beginning. And then, now you're going to add the salt. I usually do it with my hands because that way I know how much salt I'm adding. So this is salt to taste. Just keep stirring. A few drops of water at the end to mix everything in, and here it's done. It just took, after the main time that was taken was to cut the bhindis in very small pieces, and after that it literally took 10 minutes. It's done now, and you can see how beautiful it looks, green and tender here. Hope you liked the video. Thank you very much for watching.